Do you want to 3D print faster on your Ender 3 style printer? I'll show you some tricks in Cura to take a 5.5 hour printed arm and do it in 3. Right here on Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you every week by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. There are printers out there which will print faster than an Ender 3 or Ender 3 clone. Like the Voron 2, that's a real popular one right now, or a Delta printer like the Simi CNC Artemis that I have, prints a lot faster, but those will cost you a lot more money. So the question is there things you can do to your prints to make them actually print faster? Well, yeah, there is. For example, this side spool holder that I showed in a previous video, just the arm, not even the pivot, just the arm itself, if I print it at a 0.2 layer height, it would take almost 9 hours to print. If I do it at a 0.28 layer height, then I save a lot of time, get it down to about 5.5. But I had a viewer take this, change the design to a much simpler design, and get it down to about 3 hours. But I like this design with the zigzag. It looks more like, you know, Eiffel Tower type of build. Well, I was able to do that in Cura and still maintain that roughly 3 hour print. And I did it using tricks I've showed you in previous videos in Cura. So let's take this, bring it into Cura, and I'll show you how we get from this to this. Here it is brought into Cura. I'm using the Ender 3 Max machine profile to give me more space. Let's slice it at 0.2 layer height. It's got 3 walls, 15% infill, and supports just where it's touching the build plate. Slice it 8 hours and 43 minutes, almost 9 hours to print just this arm. In detail shows us it's mostly inner and outer walls taking the time. I'll use my 0.28 profile. That should speed things up with the same settings. So we'll slice it. And we get 5 hours and 57 minutes, almost 6 hours. Inner and outer walls are the main time users. It's all the inner and outer walls, and these crosses are treated as outer walls. They're nice and smooth inside, and you want the outside to be smooth because that's what you see. So it prints slower, but your infill and things like that can print faster because you'll never see it. Well, all these crosses are outer walls, so they come out really nice, but that takes time. So I had a viewer take this design and simplify it. And they actually got rid of all these crosses and just made it nice and smooth. Let's take a look at that. On Thingiverse, Builder Red Cross took the design and made it smoother. He made the top and bottom smoother and got rid of all those crosses. And in the process, it prints faster. He claims 5 hours instead of 9 hours at 0.2 layer height. And he's right. It prints faster. Let's take a look at it. Here's his design brought into Cura. You can see it's smooth on top and bottom. No more crisscrosses. I'm going to slice it at a 0.28 layer height, so it should be faster. After slicing, 3 hours and 10 minutes, so I just took it down 2 more hours. And you see the biggest category is skin, the outer skin, no longer inner and outer walls. But I like this zigzag. I like that look. That's what I want. So am I stuck with a long print? Well, no. There's tricks in Cura that you can get that same effect. Let me show you how to do that. I showed this in a previous video where you can actually make the top and bottom layers zero. So that way exposes the infill. So I set it to zero here, and let's slice it again and see how it looks. I reduced it down to 2 hours and 16 minutes, but let's take a look at it in preview. All the infill is now exposed. I'm getting a crisscross pattern, kind of. It's not the pattern that I want, but I can see all the way through the arm. So let's change the pattern. I'm going to go into the infill settings, and I'm going to change it to 10% infill like my profile normally has, and I'm going to change grid to triangles. Now let's slice it again and see how it looks. As you can see, it's starting to look more like the original, but these infill walls are really thin, so you can actually make them thicker, which I've showed in a previous video, so let's do that. I'll scroll down to the infill setting, infill line multiplier. I'm going to change it from 1 to 2, so it's going to be twice as wide. Then we'll slice it again. Let's see the result. Now those inner walls are thicker and stronger, but I've got these other areas that are exposed that I don't want exposed, like around the spool holder and then the base of the foot, and also the hinge. I want that to be a little stronger as well. So that's another trick. Let me show you that. I click on the model, and then I come to the left menu and click on Support Blocker. That allows me to put a block on the design. And then I can reshape just this block. So I click off the model and then just the block. Then I resize it. I'm going to use 50 millimeters square, X, Y, and Z. So I'll just set that to 50, and they all change. So I get a 50 millimeter block in all directions. Now I need to move this. I'm going to turn it on an angle so it's in line with the arm, and I'm actually going to position it so it's over the area where the spool holder will go, and I'm going to lower it down so it covers that whole area, and then we'll do unique settings within this block. I come over to the left menu again and go to the per model settings, and I select modify settings for overlap. I'll get rid of what's here, and we're going to select a new setting. So I click on select settings, and I want to search for top and bottom, but top and bottom are together. Top and bottom thickness. Now I want to make this 1 millimeter, so I want a top and bottom here. So I change this to 1 millimeter, and then we're good. And it's going to slice and put a top and bottom there. I place similar blocks at the base and also at the hinge. So now I can go in and do the per model settings for each of these. Basically, I'm going to do the same thing where they intersect. Make it 1 millimeter top and bottom thickness, to the same thing for the hinge, 1 millimeter. And now I can slice it and let's see how it looks. Time went back up again, 3 hours and 21 minutes, but now let's look at it in preview. All the spots where the blocks were are now solid, and the inner part is the crisscross, just like I liked, and double walled so it's strong. So let's print this and see how it turns out. The one in white is the new design. You can see they don't match exactly, but the white one took 3 hours. The red one took 5.5 hours. Is it worth the difference? Here's one I printed in black, but there was a little bit of red filament still in the nozzle, and it really came out cool. You can see the solid portions much easier in this print. And this thing is strong. It's not flexing hardly at all, and if I need it stronger, I could do 3 walls. Of course, I would add a little bit more time, but really, this is all I need. And now, 3 hours to print one of these instead of 5.5. I can almost print 2 of these versus 1. So that's how you can print faster without having to buy a new machine. Just do some tricks in Cura and maybe a few design changes. So what do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the other videos popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.